Dear students, welcome. For a long period of time, I could not take your classes due to my illness. My health was not supporting me to take any class. Today, this time presently I am fine. Today, we shall solve the remaining part of change of axis. The chapter is included in BSc third semester honors course. let us start. If by any change of axis, without change of origin, the expression ax square plus twice h xy plus by square, this expression changes to a dash x dash square plus twice h dash x dash y dash plus b dash y dash square. It changes to this. The axis in this case being rectangular, prove that, or show that, number one, a plus b, this is equal to a dash plus b dash. Number two, ab minus h square, this is equal to a dash b dash minus h dash square, and a minus b whole square plus 4h square, this is equal to a dash minus b dash whole square plus 4h dash square. If by any change of axis would have change of origin, the expression ax square plus twice hxy plus by square, this expression becomes a dash x dash square plus twice h dash x dash y dash plus b dash y dash square. The axis in this case being rectangular, show that this. You may take this is an example, okay? And you may take this is a theorem also, because these two terms, mainly from these two terms we will calculate this one, or from you will have to remember this these two terms, a plus b equal to a dash plus b dash, and ab minus a square, this is equal to a dash b dash minus h dash square. You will have to remember this, therefore you may treat this as a theorem also. Solution, let us solve this problem. Solution. Let us rotate the axis through an angle theta keeping the origin fixed, let us rotate the axis through an angle theta, keeping the origin fixed. Let xy be the coordinates of a point. Let xy be the coordinates of a point. Refer to the old coordinate axis, and x dash y dash be the coordinates
of the same point.
Refer to the new coordinate axis. XY coordinates of a point, suppose P, and refer to the old coordinate axis, and after rotation, after rotating the axis through an angle theta, let x dash y dash be the coordinates of the same point. Therefore, putting x dash cos theta minus y dash sin theta for x and x dash sin theta plus y dash cos theta for y in the expression a x square plus twice h x y plus b y square in the expression b. So as to get the expression, a dash x dash square plus twice h dash y dash plus b dash y dash square. So as to get the expression b. Putting this for x, therefore we must have a dash x dash square plus twice x dash y dash plus b dash y dash square. This is equal to, in this expression put x equal to x dash cos theta minus y dash sin theta, x dash cos theta minus y dash sin theta whole square plus twice h x dash cos theta minus y dash sin theta into x dash sin theta plus y dash cos theta plus b x dash sin theta plus y dash cos theta whole square. Now see in the right hand side how many terms are there. A plus, it is of the form a minus b whole square. There will be three terms. It is the product of two terms. Each term contains two, therefore it will from this, if you multiply this and this, you will get 4 terms. 3 plus 4 equal to 7. 7 plus 4 these terms, you will get another 3 terms. Total 10 terms will be there in the right hand side. Now, equate the coefficients of x dash square, y dash square, and x dash y dash. Now, equating the coefficients of x dash square, y dash square, and x dash y dash coefficients of iman from both sides of. Suppose this is number 1. From both sides of 1, we get. Now equate the coefficients of x dash square, y dash square, and x dash y dash. Then, if you copy the coefficients of x dash square in the left hand side, you will get a dash. It is nothing but a dash. This is equal to, we have to find the coefficients of x dash square. Here, a minus b, it is of the form a minus b whole square. A square plus b square plus twice a b or minus twice a b. If you square this term, you will get x dash square cos square theta. This means you will get a term which contains x dash square. therefore a cos this a cos square theta, a cos square theta. And from these two terms, if you multiply this and this, you will get x square cos theta into sin theta, and it is also of course multiplied by twice h plus twice h sin theta cos theta, sin theta cos theta, plus you will get from this terms b sin square theta. Suppose this is number 2. Suppose this is number 2. Now equate the coefficients of y dash square. In the left hand side you will get b dash. B dash this is equal to, you will get a into sin square theta. A into sin square theta. If you multiply this and this, you will get terms containing y dash square. You will get minus twice h sin theta cos theta, minus twice h sin theta cos theta, plus b into cos square theta. I hope you understand this. Plus b into cos square theta. B into cos square theta. Now equate the coefficient of x dash y dash. In the left hand side, you will get twice h dash. This is equal. In the left hand side, you will get twice h dash. In the right hand side, you will get, if you multiply this and this, twice a b term. Twice a b term. You will get minus a into twice sin theta cos theta. A into twice sin theta cos theta. X dash y dash plus twice h. If you multiply this term, you will get the term containing x dash y dash. X dash y dash cos square theta twice h cos square theta. Similarly, if you multiply this and this, you will get x dash y dash minus sin square theta into twice h minus sin square theta. Into twice h, and from here also plus b into twice sin theta cos theta, twice sin theta cos theta. This means you will get h dash is equal to minus a minus b sin twice theta, because sin twice sin theta into cos theta equal to sin twice theta, plus twice h cos twice theta. Twice h cos twice theta. Suppose this is number 4. Perhaps you understand this. This is twice sin theta into cos theta. Here also twice sin theta into cos theta. Minus a minus b into this. Here you see, in the right hand side of 2, there are 3 terms. In the right hand side of 3, there are 3 terms. Total 6 terms. Here 1, 2, 3 and 4. 4 terms. Total number of terms will be 10. Therefore, we have done no mistake. This means that we have done no mistake. We have written all the terms in the right hand side of the right hand side. Now, to prove the number 1, add 2 and 3. Adding 2 and 3, we get. Adding 2 and 3, we get. Adding 2 and 3, we get. A dash plus B dash. This is equal to add 2 and 3. Suppose here you will see a cos square theta, a sin square theta, a cos square theta plus sin square theta, cos square theta plus sin square theta. These two terms will be cancelled. Twice h sin theta cos theta, minus twice h sin theta cos theta, no problem. Cos theta plus b into sin square theta plus cos square theta. Cos square theta. Now this means a dash plus b dash, this is equal to a plus b. These two terms will be cancelled since sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. This is equal to 1. Therefore number 1 has been proved. In this way number 1 has been proved.
Number one has been proved. Now, to prove number two,
just let us see how I proceed. To prove number two, multiply 2 and 3 by 2. 2 implies, we may write simply 2 implies. Twice ADAS, multiply it by twice. ADAS equal to A into cos square theta. Means twice cos square theta. You may write twice cos square theta. Plus 2 times of twice H, 2 times of sin theta into cos theta. Plus B, twice sin square theta. Twice sin square theta. This. And this will be required. Therefore, I am keeping it with a box. Twice ADAS. This is equal to A. What is twice cos square theta? It will be 1 plus cos twice theta from class 11. 1 plus twice cos twice theta plus twice H sine twice theta plus B 1 minus cos twice theta. 1 minus cos twice theta. This means twice ADAS, this is equal to, here you see A into 1, B into 1. I am writing A plus B here. Plus, now write the coefficients of cos twice theta. You will get A minus B cos twice theta. Cos twice theta. Plus twice H sin twice theta. Suppose this is number 5. Now, from 3 you will get, 3 implies. From 3 you will get. Multiply 3 by 2. Twice B dash equal to A into twice sin square theta minus 2 twice H twice sin theta into cos theta plus B into twice cos square theta. You will get this. This means twice B dash, this is equal to A into, here you will have to write 1 minus cos twice theta minus twice H sin twice theta plus B into 1 plus cos twice theta. 1 plus cos twice theta. This means twice B dash, this is equal to A plus B. A into 1, B into 1. A plus B minus A minus B into cos twice theta minus twice H sin twice theta. Or you may write here twice B dash equal to A plus B into B minus A minus, minus is common, A minus B cos twice theta plus twice H sin twice theta. Twice H sin twice theta. Suppose this is number 6. Now, this is 5, it will be required. This is 4, 4 will be applied also. 4 will also be applied. 5, this 5 will be applied. 6 will be applied. Now, 5 into 6 minus 4 square. 5 into 6 minus 4 square implies. What we are going to do now, first we multiply equations number 4 and 5 and then we will subtract twice h dash square, twice h dash whole square means twice h dash whole square means 4 square. Then we square the equation number 4. Then we will subtract t square from the product of 5 and 6. From the product of 5 and 6. Therefore, now this implies 5 into 6, twice a dash, you will get twice a dash into twice b dash minus twice h dash whole square. This is equal to. Now you write here a plus b plus a minus b into cos twice theta plus twice h sine twice theta. Now this is number 5. This is number 5. Twice a dash. What is this? This is equal to twice a dash. Twice b dash from number 6. You will have to write a plus b minus a minus b cos twice theta plus twice h sine twice theta twice h sine twice theta. You will have to write this minus 4 square means minus a minus b sine twice theta plus twice h cos twice theta whole square. Cos twice theta whole square. Yes. This means, see the left hand side, 4 into a dash b dash minus 4 into h square. You may write 4 into a dash b dash minus h dash square. H dash square. This is equal to. Now see the product term. A plus B plus this. If you consider this as A plus B, it will be A minus B. It is of the form A plus B into A minus B. Clearly, it will be A square minus B square. Clearly, from algebra, you will get A plus B whole square minus A minus B cos twice theta plus twice h sine twice theta this whole square. From algebra you will get this square minus this square, because it is of the form a plus b into a minus b, minus this square minus this square, you will get minus a minus b whole square into sine square twice theta plus, you will get here 4h square cos square twice theta minus 4 times of h into a minus b sine twice theta cos twice theta sin twice theta cos twice theta. You will get this one. Oh yeah, number one minute. It is minus sign this whole square, and this will be minus 4 h square. This will be minus. Of course these terms will be plus, because minus is there, and within the bracket you will get another minus sign, consequently you will get plus sign. This is equal to a plus b whole square. Now you see, it is also of the form a plus b whole square. You will get a minus b whole square cos square twice theta minus 4 h square sin square twice theta minus 4 h into a minus b sin twice theta cos twice theta cos twice theta. Up to this we have written all terms, and just write this term a minus b whole square into sin square twice theta minus 4 h square cos square twice theta plus 4h a minus b into sin twice theta cos twice theta. You see, minus 4h a minus b sine twice theta cos twice theta, this term will be cancelled. These two terms will be cancelled. This means 4 into a dash b dash minus h dash square, this is equal to, here you see a plus b whole square minus, you see a minus b whole square into cos square twice theta minus a minus b whole square sin square twice theta minus a minus b whole square on, you will get cos square 2 theta plus sin square 2 theta, cos square 2 theta plus sin square 2 theta minus 4h square, you will get sin square 2 theta plus cos square 2 theta, sin square 2 theta plus cos square 2 theta. All terms have been written here. This is equal to a plus b whole square minus a minus b whole square. It is 1 minus 4h square, it is also 1. This is equal to a plus b whole square minus a minus b whole square is equal to 4ab. 4ab minus 4h square. This is equal to 4 times of ab minus h square. 4 times of ab minus h square. And the left hand side also 4a dash b dash minus h dash square. This means 4, 4 will be cancelled. A dash b dash minus h dash square. This is equal to ab minus h square. Proved. The second part has also been proved. We have proved the second part. To prove the third part, you will have to apply the first part and the second part. Now third part, it is very easy. A dash minus b dash whole square plus 4 h dash square, this is equal to, it is a minus b whole square. You may write here a dash plus b dash whole square minus 4 a dash b dash plus 4 h dash square. This is a simple formula. A minus b whole square, this is equal to this whole square minus 4 a dash b dash. From class 8-9 level questions. This is equal to a dash plus b dash, we have already proved. What is this? A plus b whole square minus, from this, a dash b dash minus h dash square. 4 common. Since a dash plus b dash, this is equal to a plus b. Since a dash plus b dash, this is equal to a plus b. And from these two terms, we have taken 4 as common. This is equal to a plus b whole square minus 4. Thus, we have proved this ab minus h square. Since a dash b dash minus h dash square, this is equal to ab minus h square. Since this, ab minus h square, this is equal to, from this, a plus b whole square minus 4ab plus 4h square, this is equal to, from these two terms, you will get a minus b whole square plus 4h square, a minus b whole square plus 4h square. Thus, a dash plus a dash minus b dash whole square plus 4h dash square, this is equal to a minus b whole square plus 4h square, plus 4h square. The third part has also been proved. We have proved the third part. Perhaps you understand this one. Thank you. Let us take another problem. Perhaps you have written all these things. Thank you.
This is example number. Today's, this is today's example number two.
Prove that.
Datang.
Z square plus F square in the expression in the equation the general equation of second degree AX square plus twice HXY plus BY square plus twice ZX plus twice FY plus C equals to 0. Prove that the term z square plus f square in the equation this remains constant or unaltered by any change of axis without change of origin. Prove that the term iman in the equation iman remains unchanged. Remains constant or unchanged. It is same thing. By any change of axis without change of origin. Without change of origin. The term z square plus f square in the equation this remains unchanged or remains constant by any change of axis without change of origin. Now, solution. The given equation is AX square plus twice HXY plus BY square plus twice ZX plus twice FY plus C, this is equal to 0. The given equation is this. Suppose this is number 1. The given equation is this. Let us rotate the axis. The axis through an angle. Let us rotate the axis through an angle theta. The value of z square plus f square remains unchanged. Let us rotate the axis through an angle theta. Therefore, replacing x by x cos theta minus y sin theta and y by x sin theta plus y cos theta in the equation 1 we get the transformed equation as we get the transformed equation as. Let us rotate the axis through an angle theta. Therefore, replacing x by x cos theta minus y sin theta and y by x sin theta plus y cos theta in the expression 1, we get the transformed equation as. A into x cos theta minus y sin theta whole square plus twice h x cos theta minus y sin theta into x sin theta plus y cos theta plus b x sin theta plus y cos theta whole square plus twice z x cos theta minus y sin theta plus twice f x sin theta plus y cos theta plus c, this is equal to 0. Suppose this is number 2. This is the transformed equation. We have to prove that
the value of g square plus f square remains unchanged when the axis are rotated through an angle theta, keeping the origin fixed. Then we need not simplify this equation. We have to simply prove that the value of g square plus f square remains unchanged. Now see the equation number one. What is the value of g and f? What is g and what is f? What is twice g? The coefficient of x in the equation one. What is g? Half into coefficient of x in the equation one. What is f? Half into coefficient of y in the equation number one. Now similarly in the transformed equation two also, we shall verify the half into coefficient of x and half into coefficient of y. First we calculate half into coefficient of x and half into coefficient of y. Then if we square this, then what is this? Z half into coefficient of x, half into coefficient of y. Here also half into coefficient of x and half into coefficient of y in the equation number two also. Let's see what I am going to tell you. Now equation one, from equation one, now let's see what I am going to tell you. From equation number one, twice g, this is equal to coefficient of x. From equation number one, twice g, this is equal to coefficient of x. Therefore g equal to, what is g? This is equal to half into coefficient of x, half into coefficient of x. Now from equation number one, equation number one, twice f, this is equal to coefficient of y. What is a? Coefficient of x square. What is twice h? Coefficient of xy. What is b? Coefficient of y square. What is the coefficient of x? Twice g. What is the coefficient of y? Twice f. Similarly, coefficient of y equal to twice f. This means f equal to half into coefficient of y in the equation number one. In the equation number one, I have got this. Now in the equation number two, now in equation number two, coefficient of x, half into coefficient of x. This is equal to, what is half into coefficient of x in the question? From these terms, if you expand this, you will get the terms containing x square, you will get the terms containing y square, you will get the terms containing xy. From here also, you will get the terms containing x square, y square and xy. From here also, x square, y square and xy. The terms containing in x, you will get, what is the coefficient of x here? Twice g cos theta. This is equal to half. Twice g cos theta. The coefficient of x is this. Also, x is, another x is here also. Twice f sin theta. Twice f into sin theta. This is equal to g cos theta plus f sin theta. G cos theta plus f sin theta in equation number two. Now in equation number two, same thing. In equation two, again I am writing here, in equation number two, half into coefficient of y, half
half into coefficient of y. This is equal to half. What is the coefficient of y here? Coefficient of y minus twice g sine theta. Sine theta plus twice half cos theta. Plus twice half cos theta. What is this? Equal to minus g sine theta plus f cos theta. Plus f cos theta. Thus, in equation number 2. Thus, in the transformed equation 2. Thus, in the transformed equation 2, thus in the transformed equation 2, half into coefficient of x, coefficient of x whole square. What is this square? This square means half into coefficient of x whole square. In equation number 1, in equation number 2 also, we are going to evaluate this. Coefficient of y, this whole square. In the transformed equation 2, half into coefficient of x whole square plus half into coefficient of y whole square. This is equal to half into coefficient of x is g cos theta plus f sine theta whole square plus minus g sine theta plus f cos theta whole square. This is equal to g square. Now, find the terms containing z square. Z square cos square theta, you will get cos square theta plus, you will get here sin square theta plus f square into sin square theta plus cos square theta. The twice a terms is twice gf sin theta cos theta minus twice gf sin theta cos theta. You will, these two terms will be cancelled. Finally you will get this is equal to z square plus f square. This is equal to z square plus f square. In the transformed equation 2 also, the half into coefficient of x whole square plus half into coefficient of y whole square, this is equal to z square plus f square. This proves that theory. This is constant. Half into z square plus f square, half into coefficient of x whole square plus half into coefficient of y whole square. In the transformed equation also, we have got z square plus f square. Therefore, z square plus f square is constant. Next, number 3, suppose. If by any change of axis, without change of origin, the expression ax plus b, suppose it is ax plus b, changes to a dash x dash plus b dash y dash. Prove that a square plus b square, this is equal to a dash square plus b dash square. If by any change of axis without change of origin, the expression ax plus b changes to a dash x dash plus b dash y dash, then we have to prove that a square plus b square, this is equal to a dash square plus b dash square. We have to prove this one. We are given that we have to rotate the axis keeping the origin fixed. Therefore, let us rotate the axis or turn the axis, rotate the axis
through an angle theta. Let us rotate the axis through an angle theta, keeping the origin fixed. Let us rotate the axis through an angle theta, keeping the origin fixed. Let xy be the coordinates of a point. Refer to the old coordinate axis. And x dash y dash be the coordinates of the arm. Of the same point, refer to the new coordinate axis. Refer to the new coordinate axis. If the axis are rotated through an angle theta, then we shall get a new axis of coordinates. With reference to this new axis of coordinates, x dash y dash are the coordinates of the same point. Putting x dash cos theta minus y dash sin theta for x. X dash cos theta minus y dash sin theta for x. And x dash sin theta plus y dash cos theta for y in the expression. Ax plus by. So as to get the new expression a dash x dash plus b dash y dash, a dash x dash plus b dash y dash, in the expression this, so as to get the new expression a dash x dash plus b dash y dash. Therefore we get a dash x dash plus b dash y dash, this is equal to a x dash cos theta minus y dash sin theta plus b x dash sin theta plus y dash cos theta. This is equal to a cos theta plus b sin theta into x dash plus minus a sin theta plus b cos theta into y dash. A dash in the left hand side, a dash x dash plus b dash y dash. Now equating the coefficients of x dash and y dash from both sides, both sides of 1, suppose this is 1, from both sides of 1, we get a dash, this is equal to the coefficient of x dash, is this a cos theta plus b sin theta. Coefficient of x dash is this, coefficient of y dash is equal to minus a sin theta plus b cos theta. This is number 2 and this is number 3, suppose.
scoring and adding 1 and 2 and 3 we get. Squaring and adding 2 and 3 we get. Squaring and adding 2 and 3 we get. A dash square plus B dash square, this is equal to A cos theta plus B sin theta whole square plus minus A sin theta plus B cos theta whole square. You will get this. I can write here also. This means in the left hand side, A dash square plus B dash square equal to, here you will get 3 terms from this and you will get 3 terms from this, and A square into cos square theta plus sin square theta plus twice AB sin theta cos theta plus B square into sin square theta plus cos square theta minus twice AB sin theta cos theta. These two terms will be cancelled. This is equal to A square plus B square. Thus, A dash square plus B dash square, this is equal to A square plus B square. We have proved this one. Let us take another problem. Perhaps you will tell all things you understand. If by any orthogonal transformation of axis, orthogonal transformation of axis without change of origin, if by any orthogonal transformation of axis without change of origin, the equation ax square plus twice hxy plus by square, this is equal to c. Suppose the expression imam is transformed into one in which there is no term, involving xy. If by any orthogonal transformation of axis without change of origin, that equation imam is transformed into one in which there is no term involving xy, then prove that the transformed equation is, then prove that the transformed equation is A plus B plus lambda into x square plus A plus B minus lambda into y square, this is equal to twice C. In the transformed equation, there is no term involving xy, where lambda, this is equal to root of r a minus b whole square plus 4h square, where lambda is equal to root of r a minus b whole square plus 4h square. Now see, if by the given equation is this, we rotate the axis through an angle theta in such a way that the term involving xy in the given equation vanishes in such a way. This then
the transform in the transformed equation, there is no term involving xy. We have to show that the transform equation is this. Lambda stands for root of r a minus b whole square plus 4 a square. Let us prove. Let us try to solve this problem. The given equation is ax square plus twice hxy plus by square, this is equal to c. This is the given equation. Suppose this is number one. Now let us rotate the axis. Rotate the axis through an angle. Let us rotate the axis through an angle theta, keeping the origin fixed. Let us rotate the axis through an angle theta, keeping the origin fixed. Therefore, replacing x by x cos theta minus y sin theta and y by x sin theta plus y cos theta in the equation 1, we get the transformed equation as What is the transformed equation? A into x cos theta minus y sin theta whole square plus twice h x cos theta minus y sin theta into x sin theta plus y cos theta plus b into x sin theta plus y cos theta whole square. This is equal to c. Now see, when you simplify it, you should always consider this. You should how many terms are there in the left hand side? 10 terms. From this you will get 3 terms, from this you will get 4 terms, from this you will get 3 terms. For this 10 terms, from this 10 terms, what are the terms containing x square? You see, a into cos square theta, containing the term x square, you will get this one, plus twice a sin theta cos theta, sin theta cos theta, and b into sin square theta. These terms will contain x square. Now you see the coefficient of y square. What is the coefficient of y square? A into sin square theta. Coefficient of y square, if you multiply this and this, you will get coefficient of y square minus y square sin theta cos theta. This is twice h. Minus twice h sin theta into cos theta. And coefficient of y square, you will get plus b into cos square theta into y square. B into cos square theta into y square. Now, coefficient of xy, you will get minus a into twice sin theta cos theta, coefficient of xy plus twice h. What is the coefficient of xy? If you multiply this and this, cos square theta, coefficient of xy, if you multiply this terms and this term, this term and this term, you will get the coefficient of xy with a minus sign. Therefore, you will get minus sin square theta plus b into twice heavy terms is twice sin theta into cos theta. Twice sin theta into cos theta. These terms will also contain xy. Now, count again how many terms are there. You will get, in this equation, we got left hand side 10 terms are there. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This means that we have done no mistake in writing this. This means, and in the equation which we are going to prove that, what we are going to prove that the transformed equation is a plus b x square, a plus b plus lambda x square plus a plus b minus lambda into y square, this is equal to twice c. You see, in the given equation the right hand side was only c, here it is twice c also, here it is twice c, and in the transformed equation there is no term containing xy, this is equal to c. This is equal to c. Therefore, multiply this equation by 2. A into twice cos square theta multiply by 2 plus twice h twice sin theta into cos theta. Multiply this equation by 2 plus b into twice sin square theta. Multiply this equation by 2 x square plus a into twice sin square theta minus twice h into twice sin theta into cos theta plus b into twice cos square theta into y square, into y square, and multiply by 2. Here, this term will be again 0, therefore you will multiply here also minus a sin twice theta plus twice h. What is this? It is nothing but cos twice theta plus b, it is sin twice theta into xy, this is equal to twice c. This is equal to twice c. This implies a into twice cos square theta can be written as 1 plus cos twice theta, 1 plus cos twice theta plus twice h sin twice theta plus b into 1 minus cos 2 theta into x square, into x square. This term a into 1 minus cos 2 theta minus twice h sin 2 theta plus b into 1 plus cos 2 theta into y square, into y square, and this term will be equal to plus 2 times of minus of a minus b cos twice sin twice theta plus twice h cos twice theta, this is equal to twice c. This is equal to twice c. We are simplifying the transformed equation. This time we are simplifying the transformed equation. This means here a plus b, you may write here a plus b plus a minus b cos 2 theta
cos 2 theta plus twice h sin 2 theta into x bar. You may write like this, plus a plus b minus a minus b cos 2 theta minus twice h sin 2 theta into y square, into y square, plus 2 times of minus a minus b sin 2 theta plus twice h cos 2 theta. This is I forgot to write here xy, simply xy. Here xy equal to twice c, xy is equal to twice c. Into xy, this is equal to twice c. This is equal to twice c. This is the transformed equation. This is the transformed equation. I forgot. Suppose this is number a. According to the question, there is no term involving xy, in the transformed equation A. Therefore, the coefficient of xy in the equation A must be equal to 0. Xy in the transformed equation A must be equal to 0. For that we must have what we get minus a minus b sin 2 theta plus twice h cos 2 theta, this is equal to 0. We get this one. This implies a minus b sin 2 theta, this is equal to twice h cos 2 theta. Or you may get tan 2 theta, this is equal to twice h by a minus b. This means theta equal to half into tan inverse twice h by a minus b. This means we have to rotate the axis through an angle this. Our question was not there. Our question was to find the transformed equation. We have to rotate the axis through an angle this. Our question was not that. Our question was to find the transformed equation. For that we have to find sin 2 theta and cos 2 theta from this relation, and we have to put the value of sin 2 theta and cos 2 theta in the equation number A to get the transformed equation. Let's see. Let us first find the value of sin 2 theta, also the value of cos 2 theta. Let us try to find. Now we have to rotate the axis through an angle this. Now a minus b sin 2 theta, this is equal to twice h cos 2 theta. This means sin 2 theta divided by twice h, this is equal to cos 2 theta divided by A minus B. This is equal to root of R. Sin square 2 theta plus cos square 2 theta divided by root of R. Twice H whole square plus A minus B whole square. This is equal to 1 divided by root of R. A minus B whole square plus 4H square. This is equal to 1 by lambda. This is equal to 1 by lambda. It is given, since lambda equal to root of R, A minus B whole square plus 4H square. Since lambda is equal to this, we are given. Therefore, sin 2 theta, this is equal to twice H by lambda. Cos 2 theta, this is equal to A minus B divided by lambda. A minus B divided by lambda. Sin 2 theta is equal to twice H by lambda, cos 2 theta is equal to A minus B by lambda. Substitute this value. So of sin 2 theta, cos 2 theta in equation number A. This term will be will automatically finish. Now substituting the values of substituting this values of sin 2 theta and cos 2 theta in the equation A, in the transformed equation A. Equation A we get. In the transformed equation A we get. Substitute the values of sin 2 theta and cos 2 theta in equation number A. You will get A plus B plus A minus B. What is sin cos 2 theta? A minus B by lambda. A minus B by lambda plus twice H. Sin 2 theta means twice H by lambda into X square plus A plus B minus A minus B into A minus B by lambda minus twice H by lambda into Y square plus 0, it will be 0. This is equal to twice C. This is equal to twice C. This means A plus B plus here A minus B whole square plus 4H square, you may write like this, into X square plus A plus B minus here this lambda A minus B whole square plus 4H square into Y square. This is equal to twice C. This is equal to twice C. This means A plus B plus root over A minus B whole square plus 4H square is equal to lambda. Therefore, what will be this? This will be equal to lambda square by lambda into X square plus A plus B minus, it is lambda square by lambda into Y square. This is equal to twice C. Since root of R A minus B whole square plus 4H square, this is equal to lambda. This is equal to lambda. This means A minus B whole square plus 4H square, this is equal to lambda square. This is equal to lambda square. This means A plus B plus lambda into X square plus A plus B minus lambda into Y square. This is equal to twice C, which is the required transformed equation, where lambda equal to equal to root of r a minus b whole square plus 4 ac. This is the required transformed equation. This is the required transformed equation proved. Dear students, I want to stop here. Thanks for attending the class. Thank you very much. Thank you.